Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nigger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render exposition of Luke 17:20-37. Now when he was demanded of the Pharisees, when the royal kingdom of God should come, he answered them and said, the royal kingdom of God cometh not with observation. So not with the observation that everybody can see. Neither shall they say, lo here, lo there, for behold, the royal kingdom of God is within your heart. So royal kingdom of God is within you, where the kingdom of heaven is outside you. The kingdom of heaven is the one that you can see with your two naked eyes in law and order. So when there is law and order, we say it's a heaven. When there is no law and order and people are killing each other, are stealing from each other, we call it a hell. So kingdom of heaven and hell is outside, whereas the royal kingdom of God is within your heart. It is for your own peace of mind. And is related to mind, where the kingdom of heaven is related to flesh. And he said unto the laborers, the days will come when ye shall desire to see one of the days of the Son of Man, and ye shall not see it. So he told the laborers that these Pharisees and Sadducees, the temple priest and others, they will make the whole thing corrupt, and people would like to see those days when Christ Jesus was around, but ye shall not see it, because corruption will overpower the reality. So these bishops and popes and all those dog-colored people, what part they play in Christianity when Christ Jesus said that have a direct approach to God. The curtain of the holiest of holy was torn apart from top to bottom. So where do they stand, these dog-colored priests, bishops and all these? They are anti-Christ. So you expect to perceive the royal kingdom of God when the anti-Christ ruled the world? So that's why Christ Jesus said you are lucky to see the royal kingdom of God. The other people will not see it. And they shall say to you, see here or see there, go not after them, nor follow them. So royal kingdom of God is within your heart, so you don't need to follow that it is here and there, such a person has put on the things and go there. Now here is important saying, for as the lightning that lighteneth out of the one part under heaven shineth unto the other part under heaven, so shall also the Son of Man be in his days. Now here, you know, there's a corruption again. It's as the lightning strikes in the east, flashes towards the west, so shall be the coming Son of Man. That is the same as this one, but here it's not mentioning east. Now the lightning of religious light is there in the east, but in the east they are more mammon worshippers than God worshippers. So it cannot shine there. It's shining towards the west. So people of the west would appreciate the gospel that I'm preaching through the internet. But first must he suffer many things and be rejected of this generation. So Christ Jesus said he will be rejected by this generation. Remember that if Christ Jesus is rejected, who the hell we are to be accepted by this more corrupt people in churches and in other places, Antichrist. And as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also in the days of the Son of Man. They did eat, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. So this flood, which it destroyed them all, is similar to the atomic war. So when the atomic war come, people will be there making merry, eating and drinking, without knowing that it's going to finish. Likewise also, as it was in the days of Lot, Sodom and Gomorrah, they did eat, they drank, they bought, they sold, they planted, they builded. So in the time of Noah, in the time of Lot also, the Sodom and Gomorrah, when it was destroyed, they were eating and drinking and making merry, while Lot with his family has left the Sodom and Gomorrah because they were bad people. And when Jerusalem temple was destroyed, so the people left behind in Jerusalem, because all the just people after the death of St. James the Just had left for Mount Pereira. So what was left in Jerusalem were worse than Sodom and Gomorrah. They were crook, you know, and all those crooks were then seized, and then they died of hunger and other things, which they asked for, because they asked for the freedom of Barabbas. Rained fire and brimstone. But the same day that Lot went out of Sodom, it rained fire and brimstone from heaven and destroyed them all. Even thus shall it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed. That means when the Son of Man is revealed, that this is the time now that we are trying to reveal Christ Jesus, his real self. And so this atomic war is not far away. We are making atomic bombs. So Sodom and Gomorrah type things will happen. So, but as Christ Jesus said, gospel will be preached before the end of this world. So we hope that we will be able to preach gospel to the whole world before the atomic war comes in 2012. When the Mayan calendar is going to touch zero, which is in 21st December 2012. We don't know the hour and time, but it's only our Father knows when it will be. But we are having the spirit of men. We are erring, while the spirit of God is non-erring. So if anybody possesses the spirit of God, he will tell you the exact time when the atomic bomb will be coming, and they will be playing their trick or part. In that day he which shall be upon the housetop and his stuff in the house, let him not come down to take it away. And he that is in the field, let him likewise not return back. Remember, when atomic war will happen, so wherever people are, they will be just burnt alive. Remember Lot's wife. Whosoever shall seek to save his life shall lose it, and whosoever shall lose his life shall preserve it. In Christ Jesus, we are not frightened to speak the gospel truth. So we will suffer, but we will attain our goal, whereas those who will be frightened, they will just die and they will be reborn again. And I tell you, in that night there shall be two men in one bed. The one shall be taken and the other shall be left. Two women shall be grinding together. The one shall be taken and the other left. Two men shall be in the field. The one shall be taken and the other left. And they answered and said unto him, Where, Lord? And he said unto them, Wheresoever the body is, thither will the eagles be gathered together. So people, you know, at the atomic war, the one will be left. That means we can expect the good deal of people to die. And who will be saved? Those who have tribal identity intact. Thank you very much.